Well, a very hearty good afternoon to each and everyone. At the outset, I welcome you all for this online lecture. First of all, I would like to welcome Professor V.K. Parasar, sir. He is the resource person today. There is a long list to introduce Parasar, sir. He had a very hectic schedule. He was taking an online lecture in Rabindranath Tagore University. That lecture just got over few minutes back. Again, Parasar, sir, will join us. Parasar, sir, has a long list of records. He is quite popular in Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Parasar, sir, is a professor in Department of Geology, Government Motilal Vora Mahavidyalaya, Denkanal. Even Professor sir was in Government Holkar Science College, the renowned college in Indore. And he was the former convener Indian Science Congress Association Bhopal chapter for quite a long time. Parasar sir had Parasar sir has published 20 research papers on water quality of fish. 3 proceeding volumes are edited and 2 informative books on water are published. He is also a research evaluator of 3 distinguished universities and a lifetime member of 10 Indian scientific organizations. He has organized around 60 conferences, seminars, workshops, and I have attended Professor Sir's lectures several times. His lectures are always motivating, especially for students. Before we start, let me tell you, friends, we are celebrating World Water Day today. World Water Day has been celebrated since 1993 all across the globe. This particular day is aimed at raising awareness of the global water crisis. Water is truly the elixir of life. Even Sir C.V. Raman, he has very specifically emphasized in some of his lectures and in publications, water is a true elixir of life. We take granted this common substance in everyday life, but we forget that the water is the most potent and most wonderful thing on earth. The conservation and utilization of water is fundamental for human welfare. Water has been a influential, very powerful and influential influence in the life of mankind and in the rise of any civilization. Water plays a vital role. Every day, we all, means none of the living beings can survive without water. Since morning to evening, even our body uses water in all its cells, organs, and tissues to help regulate temperature, maintain other bodily functions. Our body loses water through breathing, sweating, digestion. So it's important to rehydrate by drinking fluids and eating foods that contain sufficient food. So water plays a vital role in all our daily lives. So today we have with us Professor V.K. Parasar sir. I won't stand in between you. Once again, on behalf of Dhenkanal Science Center, a unit of National Council of Science Museums, Ministry of Culture, Government of India, I welcome you all and request Parasar sir, please. We are really very happy and honored that such a luminary is with us. And I'm dead sure his deliberations will enlighten us, all of us. Now I request Parasar sir, and special request sir, please give some tips so that water can be conserved in our even day-to-day life. And Parasar sir has done several, I mean, he has published several research papers. He has worked in the grassroots level, and he is almost associated with all the organizations, even the groundwater research department in the government of Madhya Pradesh. Parasar sir, please take over. Now the platform is yours.
Thank you, Rao sir, for giving me such honor to be interact with you all. Really, this is today's World Water Day, when we are celebrating this Water Day. In my view, we have to celebrate this day every day, because water is very precious. So we have to respect the water bodies. Anyhow, I am presenting my
Sir, click on present now.
Yes, yeah. I am present. Are you getting, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mr. Raut has introduced the importance of water in very, very few and very good words. Now, this is I'm trying to, trying to message, means I have the World Water Day 2021, and this is valuing the water. So I'm giving my presentation on the importance of water, what are the different facts, what are the challenges, and what are the solutions. Every year on March 22nd, we are observing, we are celebrating the World Water Day. And this year, the theme of this World Water Day is valuing water, respect the water bodies. How is water important to your home and family life, your livelihood, your cultural practices, your well-being, your local environment? Water is associated with all these things. So on this day, we have to record the things, we have to celebrate the things, all the different ways water benefits our lives. We have to share the things to others, share your stories to others, thoughts and feelings. So this much you can do on this precious day. So the theme is the valuing the water. The value of water is about much more than its price. If you are getting free of water, then you have no value. But suppose at one place where there is no water, scarcity of water, the price of the water is more important. So water has enormous and complex value for our households, food, agriculture, health, education, economics, and the integrity of our natural environment. If we overlook any of these values, we risk mismanaging this finite, irreplaceable water is the lifeblood of our economy. 1/5 of the world economy would grind to a halt without a reliable and clean source of water. So we rely on it for manufacturing, energy production, to transport materials across the globe, and more. Sustainable development of water resources is very important. It refers to reducing the uses of water. And after reduce it, after reuse it, it has to be recycling the wastewater. So much of water is daily we are carrying out from our houses as a wastewater. So we have to reuse this water, or you can say we can recycle this water. This is very important. So water and its sources must be respected, because if neglected or misused, they have the power to harm, divide, or even destroy the societies. So water is essential for human health, food security, energy supplies, sustaining cities, it is must, and ecosystem, because without ecosystem we can't survive. So water is essential for human health also. So how our water is important? As you know, we have the only one galaxy, that is Milky Way galaxy, that our system, solar system, Earth is a member of the solar system. And this planet Earth has atmosphere, biosphere, lithosphere, and the hydrosphere. So I am given preference to the hydrosphere. Hydrosphere means the water bodies. And this hydrosphere related with the high water cycle, because there is ocean, continuous evaporation is there, the formation of clouds, the clouds move, they strike together, then the precipitation comes. And this precipitation comes on the surface, the part of it goes to the ground as infiltration and goes as groundwater flow. And the rest of the water goes according to the slope again to the ocean. So this is the life cycle. Every component is very, very important. So the important energy is the sun. Because of the sun, the seawater is evaporating. So that is called evaporation. Radiation, evaporation, then formation of clouds, then clouds collide each other, that is condensation. Ultimately, precipitation comes on the surface, either in the form of rainfall or in the form of snowfall. So this water cycle is important. If one of the component strikes, we will have floods, or you can say drought. If the precipitation will be more, if the rainfall will be more, we will face floods. If there is no rainfall, then we will face drought. So there are water resources on the surface of the earth. There is the surface water resources or the groundwater resources. So ocean, rivers, lakes, ponds, streams, reservoirs, glaciers, wells, tubewells, canals, hand pumps. They are all different water resources, either in the form of surface or in the form of groundwater. But the source of energy, which you have seen in the hydrologic cycle, that is the sun. And the source of water is rain. You might have heard this picture in the year 2018, when there was a day zero in Cape Town, South Africa, where the rationing of water, every citizen got the water after rationing. 87 liter pani. A report that about 10 cities of world, they will face water stress. So Bangalore is one of them. Cape Town, South Africa is number one, and the Bangalore is also. So in Bangalore also we will face the same thing like Cape Town, South Africa. One more, this Chennai. Chennai is also in queue. But Chennai has 3 rivers, 4 water bodies, 5 wetlands, and 6 forest, they have completely dried in Chennai, despite having better water resources and rains also. Means about 1400 millimeter rainfall is there in Chennai. But after this only, they are also facing the water. Means water crisis is there. So Bangalore, Chennai, in other metros also, you will face the same problem. So you can live without food for more than a month, but you cannot live without water for more than a week. In some organisms, Rao Sahab clearly said that everybody has, every human being also, and some organisms also, they have water. So they, like jellyfish, it is up to 90% of their body weight comes from water. So in human body also, we have nearly 60% of water. The brain is composed of 85%. Blood is 79%. And the lungs are nearly 80% water. So we need water. We have to flush water daily. So this is very important. Global water budget. And you just come to the distribution point of view. So 1.37 into 10 raised to 8. This is a million hectare meters water, approximately, world water resource. 97.2% water in the ocean. That is saline water. We are not using it. But other words, this water is very important. 2.80, this is available as fresh water. 2.20, out of this 2.80, 2.20 is the surface water. And out of 2.20, we have further classified it, 2.15 is available as glacier. And 0.01, it is available as lakes and reservoirs. 0.04% water in streams, atmosphere, soil moisture. And 0.60% available as groundwater. So after glacier, groundwater is very, very important. And this is precious water. This is FDR, you can say. We have to recharge it. Every year we have to recharge this water. Because if we will not recharge it, it will be exhausted in the coming years. World population, today's world population is around 6 billion. But when we see by the year 2050, it will exceed 8 billion. In our country, the population is around 1.3 billion and expected to exceed 1.5 or 1.6 billion by the year 2050. So the population of India is 1.3 today, which is 16% of world population. India has 2.45% of the world land resources. India has 4% of the world water resources. So in 2025, when our population must be around 1.39 billion, it will need 1,341 cubic meter water per year. And in 2050, when the population must be around 1.64 billion, at that time, we have to need 1140 cubic meter per year water. So this much water will be required in 2050. So the important thing is we have to manage the water resources. We have to conserve the water resources because every drop of water counts. The important uses of water, this is agriculture, industries, domestic. Agriculture means 80% of water goes to agriculture, while it is from surface water or from the groundwater. And number second is the industries. Number third is domestic. And the energy, the hydro projects are there where we get the electricity. Recreation, hotel business, there are so many other things where we are using the water. Consumption of water. Roughly we can say 135 liter of water needs per day by per person. Drinking, cooking, bathing, flushing, washing clothes, washing utensils, gardening, so many things. Our Indian rainfall are one, you can say, uneven, uncertain also. If you see from east to west, the rainfall ranges also changes. Cherrapunji, we are getting more than 10,000 millimeter of rainfall. But towards Rajasthan area, we are getting only 200 millimeter rainfall. So there is drastic change. More than 10,000 east side and 200 millimeter west side. If we aware that is, we are in the top six countries in the world where the annual rainfall. We are in the top six condition, but we do not conserve the rainwater. We are not managing the water resources. In my view, we have sufficient rainfall. We have sufficient water bodies, but the question comes, we are not managing the water resources. We are not conserving the water resources. If we do, we will not water stress in the coming year also. The average annual rainfall, Indian, this is 114 centimeter approximately. And the total annual rainfall over the entire country is 370 million hectares meter approximately, you can say. So out of this 123 million hectares meter water, it lost in evaporation. 167 million hectares meter water goes as runoff, and 80 million hectares meter water goes as soil water, subsoil water. Out of this, 43 million hectares meter water in soil moisture and 37 million hectares meter water goes as groundwater. So out of this 370 million hectares meter water, only 10% water goes to the groundwater. That's why I'm saying groundwater is very, very important. It is very precious. We have to manage, we have to conserve the groundwater resources. And one more thing, monsoon is very brief. We get around 100 hours of rain. And that is storms, you can say. Not intermittent rain, but storms, 100 hours rain. So maximum the water goes as runoff. It cannot be trickled down. It cannot be infiltrated down. So globally, you can say over 80% of wastewater generated by society, it flows back into the environment, treated. We don't have the water bodies. Soil erosion, this is very, very important task. That from croplands carries away 25 to 40 billion tons of topsoil every year. And it reduces the crop yields. Soil fertility will be affected. 1.8 billion people are affected by land degradation. 30 to 40% water wasted in water distribution system in urban areas. Around 80% of water consumed by household wasted in drains as sewer. 70% of water wasted as runoff. So this much of wastage of water. And these water should be recycled or reused. Many persons talk on this. The next world war will be over water. And you see Israel, Jordan, other countries, different states, they are fighting on water. So the next world war will be over water. Our position availability wise, if you see, India's position is 93. And for water stress, we are number 23. After Israel, Israel is number one. So if these figures can be changed, if we manage our water resources. So what is the Indian situation? Our groundwater is depleted day by day. We are using groundwater in agriculture also. The surface water is going polluted every year. The rainfall is wasted. 70% goes as runoff. The population is going up daily. Water demand, if the population is more, water demand will be more. Water consumption will be more. Industrial growth, it is rising. Economic growth, it is also goes up. Water business, it also goes up. From a small bottle to tank also, we are selling in the market. Agriculture, it goes down. Our health and environment, it is also in worse condition. So, if you see all the conditions, our future will be uncertain. Our scenario, you see, the water availability in India is uneven, both space and time. Some places you will face the floods also. In Odisha also, I must be wrong, but people also face floods. And sometimes you drought also, if there is no water. This is the condition of Mumbai. This is one of the figure, you can say, this is June 3, 2003, where the persons, they come to fetch a bucket of water. This is the only on Sunday they used to come and collect one bucket of water. So water scarcity is too much. This is a Chennai's position. This is a flood position around the world, around the India. This is water crisis. Where there is no water, water crisis is there. What are the challenges? We are not getting pure water. We have to drink polluted water. We are waiting for rain. There is water scarcity. Wastewater is there. Women, they are going 3 to 4 kilometers to fetch 2 or 3 buckets of water. So what are the challenges? Publicly, we are wasting water. And ultimately, we are polluting the water. There is a global climatic changes. And 20 states of India, they are risk due to excess fluoride and arsenic. Approximately 40 million Indians are affected by waterborne diseases. 1.5 million children are estimated to die of diarrhea alone. 90% of the river, Indian rivers, they have water during the June to November at the rainfall time. But only 10% is available during the other 6 months because the rivers are not perennial. So we have to focus on these rivers also, because the rivers and the tributaries, if they are clean, they are without any encroachment, and they flow around the year, then we'll have no problem. We have to survive on these rivers. We have to clean our rivers and its tributaries. Out of 600 districts of India, 250 districts, they have been declared drought. 45% of India's land area is degraded. 90% of the sewage generated by municipal councils and over 50% of sewage discharged by municipal corporation, they goes untreated, and ultimately it goes to the water bodies and it pollutes the water bodies, rivers, lakes, whatever it is, whatever bodies they are polluting. The other challenges are the river have no flow in summer season. So every river should have flow around the year. If we do this, there will be no water shortage in the coming years. Heavy use of groundwater without charging. Groundwater is used for agriculture also. And without recharging of groundwater, we are using it. Ultimately, what will happen? We are depleting the water, groundwater. And pollution of surface and groundwater This is the utmost important task. We have to solve this problem. We have to see the surface and groundwater should not be polluted. On an average, a rural woman walks more than 14,000 kilometers a year just to fetch the water. So the women are good managers, which manages the water resources. In the COVID period, we are hand washing four times a day. If suppose four or five persons in your family, so 40 to 50 liter water we are using for hand washing. And you know, the other communicable diseases like the cholera, dysentery, hepatitis A, typhoid, they are all waterborne. And it could be prevented by hand washing. So by hand washing, we can remove all these diseases. So think, we have to think seriously, the water sewage collection. We are bringing water from the farther places to into our city. And we are flushing and carrying our waste water out of the city. So we have to carry water into the city by storing diversion pipe, pump, treat. And we are wasting waste out of the city. We have to pipe, pump, divert, treat further and further away. In both the cases, you will see we are spending a billion of money. So what to do? Like Chennai, we have to go 225 kilometers to bring water. The Chennai also 300 kilometers. The Viramgam extension project. Bengaluru, 95 kilometers. Kaveri River is there. Delhi, Tehri Dam, 500 kilometers. Hyderabad, Manjira Dam, Nagarjuna Dam. Mumbai, Vatrana, Kansa, Assa, 90 kilometers. Jodhpur, Indira Gandhi Canal, 204 kilometers. I am telling about the Jodhpur. It was having so many water bodies. So many water bodies. But that water bodies we have blended. And we are bringing water from 204 kilometers. Bhopal, Indore, there are Narmada River, 90 kilometers away. So we are bringing water from far and far places. What will happen in 2050 when there is no source of water after this? So we have to revive our old traditional water methods. Every city has so many traditional water harvesting structures. So we have to revive all these structures. And by this kind of work, we can conserve our water bodies, we can manage our water bodies. So we flush and forget. This is our mindset. So this much of wastewater we have generated, we are carrying out, we have to take it out, this wastewater to far and far places. And for this, we have to set up the STPs, sewage treatment plant. But India is a developing country. It is not more than 50% STPs we have installed. Urban places, but in the rural places, we have not yet installed single one. 10% you can say, 90% to be installed in the rural urban places also. So by this, we can reduce the pollution rate. What are the different solutions? But there is a national water policy, 2012. In which it is clearly mentioned that water legislation is must. That water availability for all, conservation of water bodies, management of flood and drought, water supply, watershed management planning, research and training, and wastage of water. So these are the must, because the water is a subject of a state. Every state has its own policy. But this is the national water policy, every state should be adopted. And in my view, research and training must be very important because each and everyone should aware about the uses of water and the conservation and management of water resources. Other solutions are we have to conserve our water through water recharge. There are so many methods of water harvesting. Or you can say water recharge, artificial recharge methods by which we can conserve the water bodies. And the recycling, reuse of municipal water and industrial wastewater. And this is mandatory for all the industries. They should manage the water resources. So recycling and reuse of municipal and industrial water, it is very, very important. Utilizing increased return flow from irrigation. So the water comes from the irrigation, from the return flow, it should be utilized. And the inter-basin transfer. In India's Ken Betwa, means MP and UP, two rivers are interconnected. Recently, one draft is prepared. And one of its inter-basin transfer is come in final shape, that is a Ken-Betwa. Ken in Madhya Pradesh and Betwa in Uttar Pradesh. And another solution is the virtual water. Virtual water means how much water is for, suppose, for cotton, for a small plant of cotton, when it comes up, when they pick up the cottons, then prepare the yarn and ultimately the cotton fabric. So how much water is needed from cotton, means from plant to sari, or plant to any cotton fabric. So this much of water is called virtual water or the hidden water. We have to adopt because agriculture is very, very important in India. And 80% water we are using in irrigation. Without knowing the knowledge, we are using lots of water. We are spreading the water in fields. So we have to use drip irrigation. And it should be adopted and minimize the water use in agriculture. And there must be a close relation of surface water and the groundwater. Because if the surface water is good, your groundwater will also be good. Then this relation to be maintained. And more water use, more energy consumed. More water you have used, more energy should be consumed. So you have to save the energy also. And groundwater to be recharged consistently. Because groundwater is very precious. It should be recharged properly. Traditional methods of water conservation to be revived in rural and urban areas. Because the traditional methods, if you see, there are so many, so different, different places, different traditional methods are using in India. So we have to maintain, we have to revive these traditional methods and the rivers and the tributaries to be clean and free from encroachment. And if we free the rivers from the encroachment, then you will say, if the surface water will be rich, your groundwater will be also be rich. Rainwater harvesting should be mandatory in urban areas, depending on the hydrogeology of the area. And for this, we have to use hydrogeologists. It should be appointed in each and every district. And for a separate groundwater department should be functioned independently. We have to restore the conventional methods, like this traditional methods, like bowdies, jodes, ponds, takas. There are so many things we have to restore. We have to revive the water, conventional water methods. We have to change the cropping pattern also of agriculture. And this is very important for agriculture. Means soil scientists, agronomists, they are coming on this clue also. We have to use the change the cropping pattern of agriculture. We have to, alternative for water crisis is the public-public partnership, public and government. This is alternative for water crisis. People should make aware and trained on the techniques of water conservation. And the people who are associated with the water business or the water work, they have given proper training. And women are important. They are trained as a water manager. Effective rainwater harvesting in urban environments. This is very important. Rainwater harvesting is must for each and everyone, because the rainfall, each and every drop counts. We have to catch the rainwater. Water conservation measures in agriculture, such as using drip irrigation, it should be adopted by one and all. And the deforested areas where land has been degraded, there should be a soil management by bending along the hill slopes and making nala plugs. It can help retain moisture and make it possible to revegetate. So any hills or any slopes, any other things where there is a deforested area, it should be by nala plugs you can retain in original shape. So sustainable water management is must by building small reservoirs instead of the few mega projects. We have to develop small catchment dams and protect wetlands. There should be a proper soil management, micro catchment development and afforestation, because it permits recharging of underground aquifers and also thus reducing the need for large dams. We have to treat and recycle municipal waste water for agriculture use also. And we have to prevent leakages from dams and canals. This is in general view of rainwater harvesting. This is a check dams. People are using this for check dams. These are the subsurface dams. This is a farm ponds we are using. This is rainwater harvesting from rooftop. How much water we are collecting. This is a formula. So area of catchment, your roof area, and the amount of rainfall in your area. And if you, you know the area of catchment square meter around amount of rainfall, when you multiply it, the volume of water received in cubic meter, you will get it. And you will be surprised. You will get around the year water from the rainfall. And the groundwater recharge in urban areas is must by recharge pit, recharge trench, tube well, recharge well. There are so many things. There are so many methods. So this virtual water, hidden water is important, because India is important exporter in world and Japan is topmost importer. So this virtual water, like if you say, take an example, 2,173 liter of water to produce 1 kilogram of husked rice. Out of this 1488 liter, jo hai, it is typically rainwater, which is 443 liter in surface or groundwater, and 242 liters of water required to carry out the pollutants produced during the process. So this is the virtual water. The survey shows that 2014-15 India exported 37.2 lakh tons of basmati. And after this, 10 trillion liters of water we have exported. So this much is the virtual water or the hidden water. You have a look of this, how much water is needed for 1 liter of milk, 1 slice of bread, 1 potato. These are the figures. 1 cup of coffee, 140. The 1 kilogram of cotton, 9,270 liters of water. 1 cotton dhoti, 2 yards, 3,500 liters of water. 1 silk sari, 35,000 liters of water. But this much water is needed when it comes in the final shape. So this is called the hidden water. 1 kilogram of rice, 5,000. 1 kilogram of sugar, 2,200. leather 250 grams 4150. So these are called the hidden water. The latest research is going on this only. And in India, there are so many places where the more water is there. Floods are there, more rainfall. And some places we are using the cash crops like coffee, like cotton, sugar. These are the cash crops. In Maharashtra, we are producing all these cash crops. And they are water scarce. The groundwater is depleting too much there. So why not we are using the other state's water for the production of cash crops? So this research is going on. And in future, we'll see something will be good about this virtual or the hidden water. In the coming 500 years, if its current food export policy of our country continues, a new method of calculating virtual water flow through trade is shown. What are the signs of hope? What are the solutions? We have to more plant to be, tree plantation must be there. There are more tree plantation. We have to reuse and recycle our waste water. We have to conserve each and every drop of water. We have to artificially recharge the water resources. Latest technologies, innovation techniques should be adopted. Proper water purification system to be adopted. Seawater desalination process, where there is water scarcity, we have to use the saline water. And this plant should be installed in the coastal area where there is water shortage. We have to install STPs, sea waste treatment plant. Because by using this, by installing all these things, we can reduce the pollution of surface water bodies and revival of traditional methods. This is one of the very good solution. In Chennai, we are using it. It is a Minjur, about 35 kilometers from north of Chennai, where this desalination plant is there. In Chennai, there are two plants are working and third is in progress. And after installing all these things, the water which comes, the cost is only 6 paise per liter. But the installation is very costly. One-time investment. And this one, Chennai is a National Institute of Ocean Technology, has developed this technology. And in the other coastal areas also, in Gujarat, one of the other desalination plant is also in progress. We have to use low flush toilet. And most of them, they are using. There are two systems. And by this, we can save about 4 to 6 liter of water by using this low flush toilet. And I have seen one dripping tap can waste 15 liter of water per day. Or you can say 5,500 liter of water per year. So we have to remove the leakages. Domestic point of view or industrial point of view, we have to remove the leakages. And this sensor-based straw valves we have to use. In some places, the toilets of airports and the malls in metro cities, they are using this sensor-based. By using this, the water flows on the urinals only when it is being used. And by this, we can save millions of liters of water by using these, you can say, innovative ideas. We have to use drip irrigation because it is used in farms, commercial greenhouses and residential gardens. But it should be adopted in all the agriculture fields because this is very, very important. Because the plants should need a little water and drip irrigation is the only solution by which we can save water also. And this is a ferrocement plant where there is a water scarcity. We have to use this type of plant. This is an alternative for expensive water harvesting containers, where large amount of water needed to store in clean form. So this ferrocement plant we can use. This bamboo irrigation northeast side, the farmers of Khasi and other, they are using in to irrigate fields of black pepper and beetle. They are using this bamboo irrigation. This is a traditional method. This is rainwater drainage. Odisha is also a coastal area where there is a shear, means two types of water. This is the blackish water, or you can say salty water, and the fresh water. So most of the open wells and tube wells in coastal areas, they contain salty water due to seepage of sea water. So Antozi in Kerala, he has innovated a cost-effective method for harvesting rainwater in coastal areas of Kerala. So rainwater is collected from the rooftops of houses and is stored in a pressure tank on the ground. And with the help of PVC pipes, water is lowered below sea level, 16 to 24 feet. And the water is retained in the underground water column, which is then harvested during summer by a simple piston pump or motor. This is a unique thing for the coastal regions. This is rainwater sewage. You might have seen knowing the name Rajan Singh Johad. He has innovated so many rivers by converting these rivers. So these water soak pits, they are called Madakas in Karnataka, Pemghara in Odisha also, then Johad in Rajasthan. They are one of the oldest system of water conservation and recharge of groundwater. So these are the constructed on the area with naturally high elevation on three sides. Soil is excavated. So these are the important traditional methods. We have to revive it. And by revival, all these things, we can manage, we can conserve the water resources. So the Bawdis, Jhalras, stray wells, they are the very, very nice water harvesting structures. And in every cities, these Bawdis are there. And most of them, they are dumping yards. So we have to survive all these things. We have to revive all these water harvesting structures. And by reviving all these structures, we can restore the water resources also. So in future, we can get water and supply the water in a particular city. This nanotechnology should be used in filtration. This is very, very important. New innovative ideas now come in the country. They have come up with a solution to this perennial problem with water purification system by using this nanotechnology. What are the solutions? We have to motivate each and everyone by saving each and every drop of water. We have to group discussion. We have promotion of these things. We have encouraged. We have creating awareness. Environmental awareness is must. We have to turning to school, college students. We lecture, come demo, the nukkar play, workshops, seminars. The role of media is very important because millions of people read the newspapers. So the role of media is must. They can spread the news. They can aware the people. And we have to give training to workers which are engaged in water sector. And the welcome news is this. Jal Shakti, this is the government, central government, announced the creation of a new integrated water ministry. And out of this ministry, we have three different missions. That is Jal Shakti Abhiyan, this to promote water conservation in 256 of India's most water-stressed districts. Jal Jeevan Mission, this is to provide 146 million rural households by 2024. They have to give connection, private water connection. And Atal Bhujal Yojana, this is the groundwater management through community participation. So the three missions of this Jal Shakti Abhiyan, Jal Shakti department, and it goes from each village. So the government of India is doing well, and in future we'll survive and we can confident on the water management side. And the national water mission is that we have to catch the rain where it falls, when it falls. So this is the motto of government of India and for the other state also. So we have to catch the rain. And we have on this auspicious day, World Water Day, we have to take oath on water. We have to save the water. We have to save the water. This oath must be taken by each and everyone. You can manage your water in your city also. As simple a process where the, suppose if the city population is 20 lakhs and around 4 lakhs families resides over there. And if you save daily, you rationing, or you can say 10 liters of water you can save daily, then but naturally you can save 40 lakhs liter water per day. So by without government support, you can save the water. 40 lakh liter of water you can save. And one more message I want to give on this auspicious day, on your birthday, anniversary day, or memorable day, you have to plant a tree at your residence, institution, office, premises. You should maintain it. And by this doing, you can save our earth, you can save our environment. And important things to remember, save every drop of water, because every drop counts. You have to stop leakages from home to society to city. You have to motivate others, aware the common man about the importance of water, and application of modern techniques to be adopted properly. Generally, 3 R is given, but I'm giving 5 R's. That is, reduce the requirement of water, reuse the water, recycle the water, and rejuvenate the water bodies. And last one is very, very important, you respect to the water bodies, because without water bodies, you can't survive. By this, you can save water, you can save your world. So this much is about water. I hope I have given a strong message for all of you to save the water resources. Thanks a lot. Save every drop of
it. Thanks a lot, sir. It's a very, very strong message from what is. Thanks a lot, sir. It's a very, very strong message to the society. Let me tell you, sir, this event was live streamed in our social media pages, Facebook and YouTube.
Really?
The link you can see. Really, this government of India's new ministry, that Jal Shakti Abhiyan, Jal Jeevan Mission, and Atal Bhujal, it's a good effort. And it's all of us should give priority. And it's our responsibility to make it happen. The tip which you have given, if one person saves 10 liter, means 40 lakh liters of water saved. And normally everybody knows 3 hours, 5 hours, that is rejuvenate and respect. That's a must. Before we sum up, may I request to all our viewers, if you have any question, please ask. You can ask Parasar sir, or you can put in our chat box also.
Sir, namaskar, sir.
Sir, he is Mr. Bandopadhyay. Yes, he is from Bardhaman, West Bengal.
Yes, sir, please.
Sir, Dr. Parasar sir, he will get put to you for your auspicious speech. Sir, I want to ask you one question. That, sir, in our state, city Burgoman. One time happened, water is too much short, and so deep it is available that the municipality imposed tax to lift water. But right now it is seen that we can overcome it. So actually, sir, underground well is exactly shortage of water everywhere in the over in the public is not. Am I too sir?
Yeah, man, I'm not getting
you. Bandhupadhyayji, can you repeat your question? Actually, it was not audible. Clarity was very less. Can you repeat? I think it's because of some network issue. Can you please repeat?
Sir,
Your question comes in the chat box.
Can you put your question in the chat box, please?
Okay.
I think some network issue is there.
Yeah.
You can put your query in the chat box so that I can share with Parasar sir. It can be clarified. Anybody else? Bandhupadhyayji, can you unmute your mic and tell?
No, he's not talking.
He has some technical network issues. No, you are audible, but it's not clear enough.
बोलिए
आप हिंदी में पूछिए.
कोई problem?
हाँ, he is having some network issue. It's part, but it's in the Burdwan city. Well, sir, before we, whatever query he is having or question, I will share with Parasar sir. So, before we end this session, Parasar sir, on behalf of Dhenkanal Science Center, I wholeheartedly thank you all. And it's very clear, I have heard you several times, the way you speak today because of throat infection and continuous since last 2 hours. Delivering lectures. So thanks a lot, Parasar sir, and obviously this will take a very strong and good message to the society. And I thank all our viewers and the followers. Please be in touch with us. Follow our social media pages. Every month, 3-4 programs are there. Till this pandemic, online or otherwise offline programs are there. So thanks everybody, special thanks to Parasar sir. Thanks,
thank you sir. Thank you sir.
We'll end the meeting. Thank you.
Should I leave?
Yes sir, yes sir. I'm ending this session. Shankar.